Hi everyone, this is Bobby Howe coming at you one more time, and what I'd like to do in this video is tell you about a recent upgrade I've made to my guitar here, this USA made Fender Tele. This is kind of a thing that's happened over time. This guitar started out like all Fender Teles do with the standard OEM pickups, and I decided to move up to the next step, what I thought was the next step. Because, as everyone knows, Fender Tele pickups are single coil, and they're noisy. They pick up noise, they pick up hum and buzz and all that sort of thing, okay? So I took those out and I put in some Seymour Duncans, what they call their hot rails set. And as a matter of fact, I have a video on my YouTube channel that tells about that. And then over time, I decided that I wanted to take even another step up yet, because I wanted to go to some EMGs, which are active pickups. The Seymour Duncans were noise canceling. They were humbucking type pickups with dual coils in each of the pickups, which is better than the Fenders, but these are even better yet, I think. I've been really happy with them, and I'm not going to change these out. I'm really, really happy with them. Okay, so these EMGs is pickups is what I'm going to kind of go into some detail about, explaining how I changed them out and so forth, because there are a couple of gotchas in there that if you don't know, they're going to get you. The gotcha will get you. But so I want to kind of go through what I did. That way, you hopefully, if you decide to invest in something like this, will only have to take your guitar apart one time instead of several times like I had to. So I'm kind of going to do this in two parts. First part is going to be, I'm going to play some for you so you can get an idea what these pickups sound like. And then in the second part, I'm going to go into exactly what I had to do to put these in and some of the things you can watch for to avoid so that you don't have difficulties as you put them in. Oh, and before I forget it, I want to make sure to mention that these are what EMG calls their EMGT system, and I'm sure the T stands for Telecaster, to fit Telecasters and similar type guitars. Okay, so let's get some twangy sounds out of this guitar. We're going to have the pickup selector switch all the way to the right here, selecting only the bridge pickup, and it gets a nice twangy sound with these pickups, just as good, if not better than the Fenders, in my opinion. And you have the added benefit of the fact that these are active pickups, therefore the noise pickup is not a problem, as they are with the original Fenders. Okay, so let's see what happens. So now we have the pickup selector switch in the middle position, selecting both pickups, and we get a little mellower sound. Let's see what happens. Alright, so now for an even mellower sound, we're going to take the pickup selector switch, go all the way to the left, and we're selecting only the neck pickup, and let's see what happens there. So let me talk just for a minute about the progression moving from the original Fender pickups to the Seymour Duncans and then to the EMGs. Okay, the original Fenders are, of course, single coil pickups, and therefore they pick up noise. That's just the nature of single coil pickups. That's just how it is. Okay, so if you go out and play in public and you have fluorescent lights or neon lights, anything like that, it's entirely possible you're going to pick up noise. And there are other things that generate noise besides just those things. Okay, so I decided to move up to some Seymour Duncan pickups, which are what they call their Hot Rails Tele Set. All right, I put those in, and there's a video on my YouTube channel that tells all about that. Okay, they were better, no question, because they are dual coils wound into each pickup instead of just one, so they're noise canceling. All right, and they were better, no question. But I wanted to move up even more yet, and I moved up to these EMGs. Back to the Seymour Duncans for a second. They weren't completely noise-free. They still could pick up some noise, okay? It's not nearly as bad, but it's still there. All right, the EMGs, I've been really happy with them. I put them in, as far as I'm concerned, they're better built. They're modular. The way the plugs plug into them, the cabling and stuff inside is a lot better than I had with the Seymour Duncans. The Seymour Duncans were a real tight fit. I had to put the cable in there in a bit of a bind. And I didn't really realize how much of a problem that was until I took them out and I saw that the shield was broken. The shield was broken because of the way you have to put that in there. It's just not made, I don't believe, to fit in there easily or properly. Okay? These EMGs fit right into the cavity just like they're supposed to. One of the things you have to be aware of with a set of pickups, no matter who the manufacturer, if you have a battery, if they're battery powered, if they're active pickups, the way that all the ones I've seen work is the circuitry is not connected if you disconnect your output jack from the guitar, not from your amplifier, from the guitar. You have to unplug it here. I have not experienced it with this setup, but I'm sure it's very similar. I have a bass that has active circuitry in it, and if you leave that plugged in for, like on a guitar stand or something, for like 2 weeks or so, that battery is really going to be compromised. It might even be dead. Okay, so it's in there, it's constantly powering that circuitry when you're not even using it. Okay, that's what you don't want to do. If you unplug your guitar at the guitar after each time you use it, now EMG tells me that that battery will last you probably about a year. One thing to be aware of before you would invest in any pickups like this is to make sure that a 9-volt battery will fit inside the chamber that is covered by this plate here that holds the tone, volume, and pickup selector switch. Okay, you take out two screws, it's real easy. And you pull that up a little bit, and then you can see if a 9-volt battery will fit in that chamber, okay? Mine was a bit of a tight fit, but it fits nonetheless, okay? The battery connector that comes with the EMG pickup set is, I had a little difficulty there because the way the wires come out of that battery connector, they come off to the side. So I had to take some wire cutters, and I kind of trim that plastic up a little bit so that battery and the connector would fit down in here. An alternative to that would be to get a battery connector where the wires come out the center. And that's a third-party thing, but that's one possibility to make sure that both the battery and the connector will fit into this chamber. So the way the EMG kit comes, everything is modular. It's just everything plugs in. There's no soldering to be concerned with. Now that's if you have more modern style telly. If you have an older telly that is like from the 50s or maybe early 60s, the way the pickup mounts for the neck pickup, it actually screws right into the body, so it's a little different. If you have an older telly, that's just something to be aware of. You can still mount the kit, okay, but it mounts a little differently to an older style telly than it does a new one. And there also, with an older style telly, may be some soldering involved on the output jack, okay? It's different from a modern style telly. But if you have a later model one, it's all modular, everything plugs in, no soldering involved. It's very nice to put in. Oh, and by the way, EMG provides an excellent direction sheet that comes with the kit, all right? So we're going to look at a few images now, and we're going to look at some of the things that have to be done to put this kit in. You have to take virtually the whole guitar apart, okay? And I'm telling you these things so that you can do it once instead of multiple times like I had to. There's a couple of little gotchas in there that if I explain to you, hopefully it'll save you some grief, okay? When I say you have to take the whole guitar apart, that's true except for some of the obvious things. You don't have to take off the tuning machines, you don't have to take off the string tree, you don't have to take off the strap buttons, and you don't have to take off the string ferrules on the back of the guitar body. You don't have to do that. But you have to take the neck off, you have to take the bridge off, you have to take this pickguard off, and you have to take off this plate here for the tone volume and pickup selector switch. And, I almost forgot, the output jack. All of those things have to come off sometime in the process. Okay, I think I've already mentioned this, but I'll mention it again in case I missed it. You have to take the neck off of this guitar in order to do this job to put these pickups in. And the reason is, at least on this one, and I can only assume it's true with all modern tellies, the pickguard won't come off unless you have the neck off first, okay? And I hope I don't have to mention, but for goodness sakes, what if you do? Don't try to take the neck off unless you have the strings taken off, all right? Take the strings off, and as if you were changing your strings, take them off and get rid of them. I don't recommend using old strings again. I've tried it. Seems like you can get them on after a lot of hassle. You get them on, and they just as sure as heck you'll break one. That's been my experience anyway. Take your old strings off, get rid of them, get a brand new set of strings. Okay, so now I want to talk about the pickup height, all right? Adjustment of the pickups as to how close they can come to the strings. You know, with the original Fender type pickups, you can get those pickups too close to the strings, and when you do, they pick up unwanted harmonics and overtones, things like that, okay? These pickups don't have a tendency to do that. You can get the pickups very close, which is what I've done, to the strings, and thereby get more output into your amplifier. And it sounds good, it's not distorted, no unwanted sounds, okay? There's only one problem. The springs that come with the kit, and for that matter, the original springs that were there for the original Fender pickups, they won't allow you to get the pickups close enough to the strings to get the amount of output that you need, or at least that's my perception, okay? I wanted more output, okay, by getting the pickups closer. All right, well, you can't do that with the springs that come with the kit because when you tighten those screws up, the springs become totally compressed and it still doesn't allow me to get the pickups close enough to the strings. So I called EMG about this problem and they said, well, a solution, this is something they do all the time, is use some stuff like you see here in this image. This is some foam weather stripping tape that you can get at your local big box store or your local hardware store. I got this at our local Ace hardware store. No plug for them. That just happens to be what's in our town. And as you can see, I got far more of this stuff than I will ever use to use for pickups on a guitar. However, this stuff is relatively cheap. Just $2 or $3 will take you all the way, all right? And you just cut off small pieces of this stuff, and then you punch a hole in it with a tool like you see here. This is an old, as you can see, an old leather hole punching tool. And you might think, gee, that thing sure is rusty, and it is. But I left it that way because it belonged to my dad, and he's no longer here. And I just wanted to leave it as it was. Okay? So you put some holes in this stuff, as you see here. And you mount these underneath the, between the bridge, either the bridge plate or the pick guard and the pickup, instead of mounting the springs. Okay, that's what you do. And as you can see, this stuff is bigger than the actual pickup up itself. It extends out a ways, and you want to trim that stuff off. Use a razor knife and trim that stuff off, trim the excess off. It's real easy. And then that way, you have just the right amount of this stuff to do the job you want. The point here I'm trying to get at is, if you have it extended beyond the pickup like that, your pickup won't fit back into the chamber that's rounded out to accept the pickup. It's made to accept the size of the pickup, not the size of the pickup with excess foam sticking out of it. That's what that's about. You can also see in some of these pictures that this is a real modular setup, a real modular way to connect things. And the cable that connects these pickups to the rest of the circuitry, that is the three-position switch and the volume and tone controls, is just a very skinny or slender cable with just three conductors. And it's quite easy to route these through your guitar and to the chamber that holds the volume and tone controls and the selector switch and wire everything up. Okay, that's why I like it. So I mentioned all of this about the foam because it will help you to mount these and have a springy action, just like springs, and without having to worry about compressing those springs all the way. One other thing it does is it gives you a better, it's like these are shock mounted a little better, and so they won't pick up any, they have a less of a tendency to pick up any unwanted noises, okay? So that's another benefit for using that foam to mount these pickups in the pickguard and in the bridge. One other thing, when you take this bridge off here, on my guitar, it has three screws underneath the saddles here. Difficult to see, but they're in there. And of course, this is without the strings on the guitar. You can get in there and you can loosen those screws up a turn or two and get them started, but it's going to be very difficult, at least I found it to be so. You can't move these saddles out of the way without them becoming in a bind. If you try to take those screws all the way out with the bridge mounted flat on your guitar as it is here, you won't be able to get them out because these saddles will get in the way and it will become in a bind. It'll be real difficult. You just can't do it, okay? Not without breaking something. You can either take the saddles off, which I don't recommend. The other thing to do is to take those screws and just loosen them up a turn or two, and then you, as you turn these screws out, you walk this bridge up. You just pull it up with the screws as you're unscrewing them, okay? And so you're holding onto this bridge and you're pulling up on it as you're undoing the screws. The screws will stay in the heads of the screws will stay in the recesses that they belong in, and you'll be able to bring this whole thing up without doing any damage to the saddles on your bridge. Okay, so finally, I'd like to say that I really like these pickups. They're modular construction. They look good, they sound good, they work well. You don't have to worry about picking up a lot of noise since they're an active pickup. You'll notice a real difference if you have to play out in public somewhere where there's fluorescent lights or neon lights, anything like that. So let's see if there's any more music left on this guitar.